And a good day, everyone. My name is Jewel. This is J7409 Weather. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking the weather out with me today. Weather in general. Well, you know, it's mostly all about severe weather today. And I'll tell you why, folks, because right up in this area here is what's called a quasi-stationary front. And it's extending from the Great Lakes area roughly all the way to the Great Basin, and it's the whole focus for showers and severe thunderstorms over the upper Midwest today. Now, this is a very enhanced risk of severe thunderstorms today, especially up over the Midwest, okay? And I'm going to tell you all about this and a little bit more coming up. We do have 16 million people at risk for severe weather today in these areas. So please stay tuned and be safe. We're looking at the NAM map this morning, but before I even turn it on and let it go, it's on the European model. I do want to say, folks, things are happening. Our country is really divided, and things are really going on. I had a protest in my town last night, and I was under a curfew until 6 o'clock this morning. My little bowdown town. Can you believe that? I think everyone has a right to protest, but let's do it peacefully. Let's pray for each other. It's the only way we're going to accomplish anything. And don't count on any politician, period, to solve it except the way they see fit, whether it's right or whether it's wrong. Come on, folks. We got to pray for each other. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to turn this on now and let it roll. So far as our system that you can't really see here, because this is the NAM map, it's down here. Well, yes, yesterday. Keep up. I'm going to have a complete forecast coming up on the tropical update weather. This is going to turn into crystal ball. It could turn into a hurricane, Cat 1 at least. I've got all of that, and people who are around right in here from Belmont, Texas, over in here to Cameron, Louisiana. That's where it looked like at one point. If you follow me yesterday, it was coming in. I think it may still come in that area at some point. But stick around. I will have a complete forecast on it. Now, back to today. Everybody, be aware. The main threat of all these severe thunderstorms, there's going to be some really large hail, damaging wind and tornadoes, folks. Now, the front will slowly sink southward to the Ohio Valley by tomorrow, and it's still going to be producing showers and thunderstorms, which may become severe. The rain is going to be really high if you're in some of these areas. Now, the rainfall could be quite high. You could have some flash flooding possible. When we look across the U.S. elsewhere, we got hit or miss showers and storms that can be found across much of the South from Texas to Florida. That's going to be going on and occurring in the next few days. Now, high pressure over the Southeast and the Pacific Northwest through midweek is looking like it's going to ensure otherwise mostly a dry pattern across the lower 48. Upper level energy, well, that's going to produce showers and thunderstorms over parts of the southern plains right on through Thursday. Now, as we look at the categorical outlook for the severe weather today, which I warned you about yesterday was coming, you can see severe thunderstorms are expected later today from the middle Missouri and upper Mississippi valleys into the Great Lakes. Now, damaging wind gusts, very large hail, and a couple of tornadoes. All of this is possible with the greatest threat expected from southern Minnesota to northern Iowa into central Wisconsin. As you can see right in here, you folks will have the most severe supercells today. That can cause all of this to happen. You need to be aware. When it comes to tornadoes, over here, just the tip of southern Minnesota and a large portion, just all of this of Wisconsin, you have a 5% chance of tornadoes popping up. From the same areas of northern Iowa, southern Minnesota, Wisconsin, 30% chance of wind damage happening today, with a 15% chance spread out all across all the way down into Nebraska, and a 5% chance goes from Wyoming over to Pennsylvania and western New York for a chance of some severe wind. So far as hail, this is where this large hail is going to happen. From northern Iowa, southern Minnesota, and a big portion of Wisconsin, you need to pay attention. This is where the largest hail should happen at a 30% chance. 15% chance outlines it everywhere else, with a 5% chance in the brown, as you can see. Now, when it comes to the upper Great Lakes area and the valley area, over these areas right in here, as you can see, now the forecasting soundings that have been done, and I've done some, this large hail chance I showed you is very, very possible, but it should be with just these supercell structures. Now, it's looking like there's great concern, I can't stress this enough, for damaging winds giving all this instability. Now, the activity should propagate across western Wyoming, as you can see where it starts, okay? And then, what it's going to do, it's going to march right on across, just like this, as you can see. It's spreading right into the Ohio area, right in here. As you can see, it spreads out, and it should get over into the Ohio area later, possibly after sunset and the pre-dawn hours. Now, when we look to eastern Wyoming, it's looking like the surface front is forecast. This surface front, quasi-surface front I told you about, it should settle south across the high plains of eastern Wyoming, and it's going to have a northeasterly upslope flow developed by this afternoon, sometime late this afternoon, and the boundary laying heating and orographic forcing, it's looking like isolated supercells may develop along the southern fringe of the mid-level flow. Now, this activity should spread southeastward to the Nebraska Panhandle during this evening, as you can see where it's marginal, and then boom, it's going to explode. So folks, please be safe and please be careful. Please keep your eyes on the sky for this severe weather, because it's coming up. Now, as we take a look at the watches and warnings map, you can see over here in this area of Wisconsin and in upper Michigan, right in here where you see that tan, right now you guys are under a special weather statement. You're already having storms to pop up and occur with half-inch hail that's very possible. Now, as the day goes on, this will increase and it will move a little more down south as the system moves through, as I've just showed you. Still got flooding going on. Colorado, Utah, Wyoming, Montana, and North Dakota. You are under a flood watch. Excessive heat still going on from parts of California down into Arizona and in Nevada. With excessive heat, very, very excessive heat, it's going to be another hot one. And we have severe thunderstorm warnings everywhere in the orange for California. As the day goes on, this should move up into this quasi-stationary front and move on along and out. But in the morning hours until, I'd say, early afternoon, you guys over in California could have some severe thundershower activity going on. For the rest of the U.S., it is looking gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. I've showed you where the severe weather should be today. Everybody else, enjoy your day, because more of this stuff will be coming along, it looks like, in a few days. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching, subscribing, sharing this information with your family and friends, keeping them safe, and helping me to keep you safe also. I appreciate it very much. May each one of you have much peace, love, and kindness in your lives. Thanks so much for watching.